that I want to say just a word about before the singing. This has been one of the greatest songs on late out of ours. Sister Vestal was talking about Jesus saving you. All you have to do is to believe on him.
Yeah.
The other night in Atlanta, Georgia, somebody asked me tonight a question that I was so happy that I could witness to. Backstage, some people said, I heard that a quartet really turned their life over to the Lord and started really on the right track for the Lord. Got saved, joined the church, got baptized, I don't know, you know. And I said, yeah, it's the truth. It's the truth. Right on this stage, you've seen and heard the famous Blue Ridge Quartet, Laverne Tripp. Oh, God, got a hold of that old boy. And he, you talking about all shook up, but he is. And Burl Street from the bass singer. I heard tonight that I think all the rest of them that come along followed and give their heart to the Lord. Somebody might say, well, now I thought they were Christians to start with. Well, they didn't do a lot of testifying and tell you there was a lot. But they sung beautiful songs. But they kept singing them and kept writing them. God kept his hand on them. And finally got them in the channel where they can really do something for God. Pray for them, that they'll just travel on for the Lord. And that night in Atlanta, Johnny Cook Laverne was laying down, and Laverne Tripp was laying down in our bus in the floor. Johnny, he's a Baptist boy, belongs to the First Baptist Church. You know, there's a lot of shouting Baptists. A lot of shouting Methodists. A lot of people don't do nothing but cry when they get happy. But if you're saved, there's something just kind of turns over inside. I don't care who you belong to or what church, I mean, but if you belong to God. But anyway, and Johnny comes in. He started playing, praying for Laverne and on our bus. Laverne said, I got to get humble. He said, I want to lay in the floor. So he laid down flat on his back right in the middle of the floor. And then he said, what would some of my fans think about me? See me lay down here? And then he said, Vestal, I don't care. And then Johnny stepped up on the bus, and he didn't really know what was going on. But he started in heavenless praying, praying. Then the Holy Spirit fell on Johnny. And we just had a terrific time in that bus, and people that passed by thought probably we were just going to nearly turn it over, Johnny. Johnny's sitting there in the floor, and he didn't hardly know what was going on, and the boys couldn't get in there to get dressed. And I told our driver, I said, Charles, I said, you get a hold of one side of him, and I'll get on the other. So we just picked him up and set him down in the seat, and he's still praising God. He didn't hardly know what was going on, having his step behind him. Lost in the spirit. Well, you say, well, I don't believe in that, and I don't want that to ever happen to me. Well, it won't. But but don't begrudge nobody else from having it if you want to just have a good time in the Lord. Amen. God won't run over you and knock you down. But every blessing is yours tonight, regardless of what church you belong to. And it's through and by the lovely name of Jesus, we're what we are tonight. Johnny, son.